Sadly, this time of the year, criminals try to take advantage of the hectic pace of life during the holiday season. So how can you stay safe and secure? News 8's Kent Pierce live in our New Haven newsroom with some information that you need to know this time of the year. Kent.
Yeah, Keith, there are some Grinches out there who want to steal your Christmas. So how can you keep you, your family, and all your stuff safe from the bad guys? Well, we've got your back with tips from one of the good guys, Fairfield's police chief.
Criminals view the holidays a lot different than we do. They're looking for people who are unaware of their surroundings and are vulnerable.
And one of the places you are most vulnerable is in the mall parking lot, especially after dark. But there are some simple ways to stay safe, according to Fairfield Police Chief Gary McNamara.
One example is a flashlight. You know, we use it at home if it's dark out, but you can see that's really pretty blinding. Also, it kind of gives you a good indication of if there's anybody around your vehicle. Another idea is not only visual, but sound. As you can tell, very, very loud. It does a couple things. One, it gets people's attention. If you're nervous, people are automatically going to look where that noise came from.
You should also park in well-lit areas, always be aware of your surroundings, have your keys ready before you get to the car so you're not fumbling and vulnerable, and keep your purse or wallet close to you. And when you put presents in the car and go back for more, do this.
Not a good idea to leave them in the car. What we recommend, obviously very simple, just put them in the trunk. And, you know, and then they'll stay.
And if you get gifts delivered, be careful. There are crooks who follow delivery trucks and swipe packages from front steps.
We're encouraging people to either have them delivered to the back of the house, or more importantly, have them delivered when you're home, or look for a neighbor who's home most of the time, have them delivered there, or have them delivered to your work.
All right, so you've done all the shopping. All the presents are wrapped with care. Now it's time to go over the river and through the woods to grandmother's house. How do you keep your house safe when you're not there?
For one thing, turn off your holiday lights. They're a fire hazard and they signal that no one's home. Have a neighbor keep an eye on your house. Use timers to turn your lights or TV on and off, and it'll seem like someone's home. And don't display your tree and all those gifts right in the front window for all the crooks to see.
If no one's home and there's packages on display in the windows, or it looks like there's things to take, they'll try to make entries.
And of course, if you see suspicious people or activity, say something, call the police. Live in the New Haven newsroom, I'm Kent Pierce. Keith?
Kent, you had that horn in the piece.
The air horn, yeah.
Now, what's the advantage of that over other typical safety tools?
Well, what's nice is that unlike mace, a knife, or even a gun, it can't be turned against you and hurt you. All a bad guy can do with it is make more noise, which attracts more attention.
All right. Makes a lot of sense. Kent Pierce, thank you.